Hello students, in the last video we had studied about the impact of government policy changes on the business and industry, especially in respect of liberalization, privatization and globalization, which we can say that has been positive. In today's lecture we would be studying about the managerial responses towards these changes in business environment, and also we would be studying about demonetization. The first managerial responses that we are going to study is diversification spree. Now basically spree means a sustained period of unrestricted activities. So we can say that the corporate now are diversifying their business. The corporate see now witness a spate of diversification. That means companies are trying to diversify their business. For example, AT&T served initially a wide range of telecom. Now it has entered into manufacturing of transmission equipment, switching equipment and wireless products. Similarly, Reliance has diversified into textiles, petrochemicals, IT, communication, etc. Then your LG, Samsung have also diversified their activities by adding more products into their portfolios. Next is joint ventures or consolidation of multinationals. Now, most of the multinational companies came to India through these joint ventures. For example, your Ford enters with Mahindra and Mahindra, then Jaguar enters with Tata Motors, General Motors with Hindustan Motors, etc. Next is brand building. Now, after this new economic policy, the brand building, goodwill, and image of company has become an important element for promotion of companies. Their expenditures were enhanced so that they can build their image, they can build their goodwill or brands. Now they are basically spending more amount on the promotional activities such as advertisements, sales promotion, etc. for brand building, especially in consumer durable industries such as Samsung, LG, Sony, etc. Use of latest technology. Now this use of latest technology has become the slogan of the successful companies to get the first mover advantage. Now companies are trying to get the latest technology first in their product. Their expenditure on research and development also increased, especially in the companies that is related to your IT, computer, phone, manufacturing, etc. Then next is sharply improved compensation levels. Now with the entry of MNCs, there's a lot of change seen in the salary packages of all the employees in managerial as well as technical services. Their compensation levels increase. The starting salaries for engineering and management graduates have increased significantly. Now after this, the companies are following the link bonus schemes, incentives for better performance, etc. Then last is customer focus. Now, the focus of marketing, as we know, is totally shifted from product to, or sorry, we can say from producer to consumer. Now, increased attention to customer needs and their satisfaction has been taken care of. Even after sales services has become very important to satisfy the customers. Companies are providing 24/7 complaint registration services through toll-free numbers, etc. Then marketing research, advertising, sales promotion techniques like buy one, get one free have become more significant. The public relations has become a very important element of promotion. Demonetization. Now we all know about this demonetization, that on November 8, 2016, the government of India made an announcement with profound implication for the Indian economy that the two largest denomination notes, 500 and 1000, were denominated with immediate effect, ceasing to be legal tender. Now people at that time were advised to go to the bank to replace the old notes with the new up to a limit. There was a restriction on cash withdrawal also. The aim of this demonetization was to curb corruption, check on use of high demonetization notes for illegal activities, and especially the accumulation of the black money generated by income that has not been declared to the tax authorities. Now, few features of demonetizations are, it is viewed as a tax administration measure, which means that due to this demonetization, people had to declare their cash holding to get it exchanged from the bank. So those having black money had to declare their unaccounted wealth and pay taxes at penalty. Then it is interpreted as a shift on the part of the government indicating the tax evasion will no longer be tolerated or accepted. It creates a cashless economy, that is, channelizing more savings through the formal financial system and improving tax compliances. Now, this demonetization has impact on certain areas also, like in the area of money or interest rate, there was decline in cash transactions, then bank deposits increased, there was an increase in financial savings. Then if we talk about digitization, so digital transactions among the users increased, that they started using rupee, etc. Then real estate, the prices declined. Tax collection, there was a rise in tax collection because of the increased disclosure. To sum up, today we had done the managerial responses. So we can say that in today's business environment, a businessman can survive and remain in the market only by adopting qualified personal experts, then by adopting the latest technology, keeping in mind the global competition, by building or creating a brand image in the mind of customer, then by understanding the requirements and needs of the customers and always trying to satisfy the customers, and by keeping their employees satisfied by paying them fair compensation. And we had studied demonetization also. So these are certain questions based on the topic that we had done today that you have to do in your notebooks. This is the mind map of the chapter. As I have told you earlier also, that you can make your own mind maps for the chapters by using different color pens. So to sum up this chapter, we have done the meaning of business environment. Then we had done the features or characteristics of business environment, importance. Then we had done the five dimensions or general forces of business environment, that is your economic, social, political, technological, and legal environment. After that, we have done the new economic policy 1991 and the three reforms that came with that policy, that is liberalization, privatization, and globalization, LPG. After that, we had studied the impact of government policy changes on the business and industry. We can say that the impact of LPG on business and industry. Last, we had studied the managerial responses to the changes in business environment and about the demonetization. I hope, children, you are clear with this chapter. Thank you.